So good morning guys. Now today we are going to study the measurement of high resistance. Welcome to the EasyTech education, and in this education platform we provide free education to all of the students, technical free lectures, okay, including theory discussion plus numerical solving problems. So it contains measurement of high resistance. First of all, again I would like to remember you, resistance we have classified into three categories, okay. It was low resistance, it was medium resistance, and it was high resistance. Resistance classification were there, we have already gone through that part. And the value of the low resistance is whenever the resistance value is less than 1 ohm, the resistance will come into the category of low resistance. Whenever the resistance value coming under this range, if the resistance value is less than 100 kilo ohm but greater than 1 ohm, then the resistance will come into this category, medium resistance. If the resistance value is greater than 100 kilo ohm, then the resistance will come into this high category, high resistance. There were different methods are available to measure the resistance, okay, like low resistance, Kelvin double bridge, ammeter voltmeter method, and many other methods are there. Medium bridges, medium for medium resistances, Wheatstone bridge method, ammeter voltmeter method, okay, and substitution method also is there. And for high resistance, there are four kind of methods are available for high resistance measurement. First, loss of charge method. Second one, Meager method. Third one is actually direct deflection method. And the fourth one is mega ohm method. Okay, and among these four methods, these are the four methods used to find out the high resistance value. And the among these four methods, this is the most important method. You should have a clarity on this. This is the most important method. In every year in the GATE examination, you may find a question from this method. If the question comes from the category of the measurement of the resistances, either it will be based on Wheatstone bridge or it will be based on the loss of charge method. So in these we will solve, we will first understand the theory behind loss of charge method, why the name is loss of charge, what do you mean by loss of charge, okay, and why this method can be used to find out the value of the high resistance. One of our student, Mr. Madhusudan Agarwal, was asking, Madhusudan Dadich, I think, was asking that, sir, why we cannot use the medium resistance to find out the low resistance value, medium resistance method, okay, like Wheatstone bridge method, to find out the low resistance value. So I would like to tell him that this resistance, this method with Wheatstone bridge method can be used, okay, to find out the medium resistance, because low resistance value can contain the resistance of the lead wire connection, okay, like galvanometer lead wires to connect with other resistance value. So that may contain lead wire resistance, and this galvanometer cannot deflect directly the resistance of those lead wires, okay, so that may include some error also. So this method cannot be used for finding low resistance value. Wheatstone bridge method cannot be used for that. Now we are going to study the loss of charge method. Loss of charge method includes systematic diagrammatic. So we have to first of all draw a diagram for this. This is the electrostatic voltmeter, this is the electrostatic voltage supply, this is the switch, and I think this is the voltmeter. that is used to find out the value of the resistance. Here it is capacitor. Okay, and this may include another switch, and this is the value of R, whose value is to be find out. This is the value of C, switch 1 and switch 2. This is voltmeter and this is supply. Okay, this will be current. So loss of charge method, that means we are going to provide some charges to the entity that is known as capacitor. Capacitor will store charge. Now after some time in the process number second, okay, in the second process, loss of charge will take place. That means the charges that are stored by this capacitor, that charges will be lost in the resistance value. That is why it is known as loss of charge method. First we are going to store the charges into the capacitor, and in the second process we are going to lost these charges to the resistance value. And according to the theory, according to the formula, we can find out the value of RT. But before this, we have to be very well known about the values of some capacitor and voltages, whatever the entities will be there in the formula, in the derivation. So let's derive the formula. You all know very well that if this is a resistance, if this is a capacitor value, and if you charge this capacitor by some supply V, okay, by some supply, you can mention this supply as a V, okay, this is voltmeter. After some time, this capacitor can contain the voltage equivalent to VC, and the expression for VC and V can be written as V naught e to the power minus t upon RC, where RC is time constant. Okay, where RC is time constant. From here we can write down, okay, you may be confused, so how can we derive this formula? So for this formula, the derivation for this formula, you can prefer my network theory lectures. Okay, there I have dictated this formula, and how can we find out this formula? Okay, so directly I can written here, I can write here. So from this formula we can write down, if I take this term to the left hand side, it will be e to the power minus t upon RC, and if I take this term in the denominator of V naught, okay, let me take logarithm, it will be ln t upon RC. And ln V naught upon VCT. So from here, R will be equivalent to T upon C ln V upon VCT. Please note down, this has the base value E, and okay, ln has the base value of E. Okay, if you want to convert this ln E into logarithm, the base value of 10, the formula will look like 0.4343 t upon C log value base t upon VCT, and it will be, I think it will be in ohm. Okay, so this is the procedure, and this is known as loss of charge method. Okay, so this formula you can note down, and this formula can directly be used to find out the unknown value resistance, that is high resistance value. Okay, so we are going to solve one numerical based on this formula. So let me erase this derivation. I am not going to erase this formula. It is equivalent to ओके सो द एग्जाम्पल नंबर वन, एग्जाम्पल बेस्ड ऑन दिस मेथड, यू मे नोट डाउन. इन द लॉस ऑफ चार्ज मेथड द वोल्टेज अक्रॉस द कैपेसिटर ऑफ 0.4343 माइक्रोफेरड इज 10 वोल्ट एंड इट इज डिक्रीज्ड टू 1 वोल्ट इन 2 मिनट व्हेन द स्विच इज ओपन, देन द वैल्यू ऑफ द अननोन रेजिस्टेंस इज. ओके ओके माय फ्रेंड्स, लेट मी मेंशन ऑल द वैल्यूज. ओके, अकॉर्डिंग टू द फॉर्मूला, इन द लॉस ऑफ चार्ज मेथड द वोल्टेज अक्रॉस ए कैपेसिटर ऑफ 0.4343 माइक्रोफेरड, दैट मीन्स द वैल्यू ऑफ द सी इज गिवन, दैट इज 0.4343 माइक्रोफेरड इज गिवन इज 10 वोल्ट. ओके, सो दैट मीन्स इट वॉज इनिशियल चार्ज, इट वॉज इनिशियल चार्ज 10 वोल्ट. And now it is decreased to 1 volt. That means this VCT. 1 volt in 2 minute. Time is given 2 minute. We have to, if we want to use this time in this formula, then we have to convert this minute to the second. That will be equivalent to 120 seconds. When the switch is open. Then the value of the unknown resistance is, it is already mentioned that this in the first line, that in the loss of charge method, okay, we have to find out the value of RT. Obviously we will use this term in the formula. Solution will be like 0.4343 into t is what, 120 seconds. Okay, c, what is the value of c? 0.4343 microfarad. That means 0.4343 into 10 to the power 6, it is minus 6 because micro, 1 micro is equivalent to 10 to the power minus 6 log base 10. Okay, it is log base 10 V naught upon VC. What is the value of V naught? 10. What is the value of VC? It is 1. Okay. What will be the value of this resistance? It will be in ohm. Unit will be in ohm. So it will be 120 mega ohm. This will be answer. Okay. So you can find out the value of the high resistance, that is 120 mega ohm equivalent to 120 multiplied by 10 to the power 6 mega 6 ohm. Okay, so this was the charge method. In this method, the first process, I think I forget to explain the derivation. This is the, in the first method, in the first pro, in the first stage, you are going to S1 as close and S2 as open. Okay, so it will be close and it will be open. So this capacitor will charge some values. Okay, and in second process you are going to open this S1 and you are going to close this S2. So the circuit will contain this capacitor and the value of resistance. So the charge that was stored by this capacitor will be discharged into the resistance value. Okay, so it can be discharged. So that was loss of charge method. So that's why it is known as loss of charge method. And this was the numerical based on this formula, and we have put all the values required in this formula. Okay, and we can find out the value of the unknown resistance, that is high resistance, 120 mega ohm. Okay, if still if you have any doubt, then you can message me, okay, in the below link in the comment box, and you can mail me or you can WhatsApp me also. Okay, so that was the, actually it was 60% important in the measurement of high resistance. Okay, other techniques are mega ohm method, direct deflection methods, okay, and one of the method is also, that is Meager method, that are also important, but this was the most important formula. So we will meet you in the lecture number 11. This was lecture number 10. You can read. I always forget to mention this lecture because it is not important to mention the lecture number, because it is important, but yes, it is important to focus on this derivation including numerical solving problems. So I hope you are getting concepts, okay? And we will slowly move to the wattmeter method. Okay, after this we will slowly move to the wattmeter method. How can we measure the wattmeter, three wattmeter? How can we measure the power consumed in the three phase circuit, balanced or unbalanced? Okay, what number of wattmeters are required to measure the power consumed in the three phase loads, whether they are balanced or unbalanced, whether they have four wire, three wire? We will study, we will make a chart that will be used. You can take the screenshot of that chart in that lecture. That will be definitely useful for you in the competitive examination to face the questions, to tackle the difficulty level in that examination. Okay, so thank you so much. We will again meet in lecture number 11. Thank you.